So LinkedIn is one of the best tool to generate leads, to close your sales. And it's basically a tool where you can get thousands and even millions of leads for your software business, for your web design business, and whatever tech business you are in, you can find, you can generate leads, and you can exactly pinpoint the decision makers through the tool which is available in LinkedIn called Sales Navigator. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how you can generate leads using Sales Navigator, how you can use filters, how you can use leads and generate more leads to enhance your business. So if you want to learn how to use LinkedIn Sales Navigator to skyrocket your business, watch the complete video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you want to keep learning more about the sales tips and techniques. So without further ado, let's get into the screen. So we'll be learning these three things in this video: how to build lead lists using Sales Navigator, how to prospect the lead, and how we can use alerts and email settings to nurture the prospects, right? So that's my LinkedIn profile. And all you have to do to navigate to Sales Navigator is click on this top right Sales Nav icon. And I'm going to click there. And here's how Sales Navigator looks like. So we have home, accounts, leads, messaging, and all of these tools through which we can generate leads. So first, let's check out the lead filters of how we can take out the leads. So these are the lead filters. So if you want to search, if your prospect is, if you know the company, if you are finding someone on a specific company, you can simply add in the name of that company. For example, this J. Patrick and Associates. If I click on include, it will take out all of the LinkedIn profiles of those companies which are currently employed with that company. So 27 results for that company, but I don't need that. What I need is software or digital marketing agencies in New York or in Boston. So what I'm going to be doing is add some filters here, and I'm going to explain you guys step by step about each filter, how they work, right? So let's first discuss the company headcount. So assume you are looking to target, what we do in our company is that we target small digital media agency. So I'm going to add self-employed. So if an individual person is running an agency, he might need outsourcing services. So we definitely want to contact him. And we also want to prospect. We also want to add the prospect as 1 to 10. So whoever have a company headcount of 1 to 10, they might need help with design and graphic services and web design services. So I'm going to add in 1 and 10. So past company, I don't need that. If you are looking to target someone who you know that worked with that specific past company, you can add in their company type. So I am going to add in the company type. I think I don't care about what's the company time, but I don't need the public company, so just leave it as it is for now. Company's headquarter location. So I'm targeting the company which are in New York, and let's target Boston as well. You can also target the whole state as well. If you just type in the whole Massachusetts state, you can just add and target that. I'm just currently showing you guys as an example of how you can use the Sales Navigator tool, just by giving you an example scenario of how you would find the CEOs and decision makers of digital marketing agencies located in New York and Boston. So that's an example of the scenario which I'm showing you guys to how you can use Sales Navigator to generate leads of companies, digital marketing agencies located in this region. Now let's add the function of the company, that what are the functions and what are the functions that this company operates in. So we are looking for digital marketing agencies. So we can add in marketing, and we can add information technology. Where's the information technology? It was just right there. Here it is. So in information technology and arts and design can also be a category where if someone looking for a web design or a art. And we can now add in current job title. In current job title, we have, you can say owner or CEO. So we have owner. Owner is basically a decision maker. And if you contact, if you add in to your list, owner or HR manager or whoever is the decision maker, you can create a lead list which will be targeted to add into your prospect, right? So human resource manager is also our decision maker for hiring decisions. So we'll include that. And what more titles do we have? CEOs. Do we have CEOs in here? Yes, we do have CEOs. So we are creating a lead list where we will send messages to companies present in New York and Boston, possibly the digital marketing agencies. So we currently have 2000 plus results, and these are a lot of results. So we'll filter down it more to get more targeted lead lists so we can send them messages to for the prospecting. Cool. And we can also select seniority level. So if you want a senior manager or something, you can add in like owner, partner. You can filter down, narrow down your 2000 plus results, because obviously reaching out 2000 plus prospect is going to be a little hard. So we'll filter it down to at least 100 to 200 so we can send messages and create a lead list, which I'm going to show you guys. Years in current company, we want them to be at least 1 to 2 years so they can make hiring decisions, right? So let's make it to 1 to 2 years and 3 to 5 years. So nothing for less than 1 year. They should be more than 2 years or more than 10 years so they can make hiring decision. Obviously, if someone is hired just recently, he's not going to be able to make hiring decisions and he won't be a good prospect for you. Years in current position, you can also add that. Also, you can have personal stuff mentioned here. So we added the location filter for the company. So we mentioned here that company headquarter location, New York and Boston. So it's for the company location. But if person is working on the remote basis or if it's located somewhere else, we can add the filter for that specific person. So for these leads, we can add at the personal level, we can add the filters as well. Okay. Buyer intent. So if they have viewed your company or if they have following your company, you can toggle this off. So currently there aren't anyone who have viewed my profile or following my company. So there is no filter activated. But if someone in this lead list have followed your company or viewed your profile, you'll be able to see that here. Best path in. So if there are your first degree connection, second degree connections. So if you're not aware of first degree connection, meaning that they are directly connected via LinkedIn profile, via your personal LinkedIn profile. And second degree connection means if you are connected to someone and they are connected to that specific person, that's called second degree connection, or similarly third degree connection. So you can add that filter as well. So let's add in second degree and third degree connections to filter down our list to be more toned down so we can create a fruitful lead list, right? So that's also really good filter which is available with Sales Navigator. So all these filters are available in Sales Navigator. The default search in LinkedIn does not have these filters. So that's why it's a paid tool. It's currently on $100 a month. Maybe when you're watching this video, the price have already increased. So I don't know, but it's a really good tool, great tool if you are generating leads and trying to create a cold email list or cold messaging list via LinkedIn messages. So that's really good thing. As you can see, we have these here change jobs. So if someone have changed a job, we can just filter it out. Or we want the active members. So there are many LinkedIn members who are not active, who do not even check their LinkedIn profile. So we don't want them obviously on the lead list because that's going to be a really long way for them to respond us back, right? So we'll just select this one where we'll see they posted on LinkedIn recently. So I'm going to filter. I'm going to toggle this on. And here we have our lead list ready to be saved. We have 197 results, which we will be contacting, right? Now, what you can do here is you can filter out more by adding the account list and lead list. So if you have already created an account list, you can simply select that list and it will filter out those leads out of that. But for now, what we need is to save this list, right? So we will go through the title and go through the company. If it's relevant, we will simply select them. Or we can also select all by checking mark here and we will save it to list. So I have already created a list here. I'm going to create a new list. Let's name it decision makers New York, Boston. Digital media agency. It's a big name, but you can add whatever list name you want to add. You can also add lead description if you want to, and I'm going to click create and save. Lead list has been created, which will show up here. So if I open that in a new tab, just to show you guys how it's going to work. So that's how our lead list is showing up. We can simply go to that lead and to that lead list, and we can message them. So here we select these three small dots and then message. So we have 100 credits remaining. We can send 100 in-mail messages to reach out these and to offer whatever services which we are offering. Alternatively, what we can do here is we can save the searches. So obviously you have added the filters, thought about the filters, and you don't want to come back again on Sales Navigator and add in those filters again to find the leads. So what we're going to do, we'll just simply save this search. So just toggle this on and your search has been saved. Now all you have to do is just come back to LinkedIn, click on Sales Nav here, and just go to your save searches by clicking here. And you will have access to all of the filters just by one click. Simply open up the Sales Navigator and click on this save searches to carry out your search for the leads and prospect which you want to add to the lead list which we created here. So currently we have 25 results. If you want to add in more or tone down it further, you can do that later on. Now let's take a look at the accounts. So you can also search for accounts, meaning companies. So let's open that in a new tab where I'll show you guys what are the filters which we have in account section. So click on account filters. And here we have the filters through which we can search the companies. So if you want to search the company where annual revenue is, let's suppose if you're looking for a small business, let's add in $5 million, $0 million to $5 million. Should be the revenue of that company. Company headcount should be 1 to 10. Obviously, we're looking for the small and medium-sized marketing agencies, right? So that way you can search the company's accounts on LinkedIn, and then you can find employees within that company, right? So we want to find companies less than $5 million revenue, and company headcount should be 1 to 10, and they should be hiring. So there's a filter here where we can search for the job opportunities. So here we have 200K LinkedIn companies looking to hire, right? So these are the good number of leads which we can generate from here and add them into our prospect list. We can also add in company headcount growth, meaning if their headcount growth is more than 2%, meaning they're actively hiring. So let's add in 3 here, minimum should be 0. And let's add in that company headcount growth. Okay, we have 60,000 plus results. Again, it's a lot of results, so we'll be trimming down it more. Let's add in the location. I'm going to add in the location to be more specific, like New York. As I told you guys, we'll be searching for the digital media agencies in New York and Boston. Okay, we have added the headquarter location, and now we have 1,000 plus small medium businesses which are actively hiring on LinkedIn, right? Now let me show you some other cool features in the account section of the LinkedIn. So for example, a company which you find out you think it's a potential prospect, so you can simply find the decision makers and message them. So I'm going to view company, click on these three small dots, and then open that up in a new tab. So here's all of the details of the company. You can see the decision makers here. So we have 31 employees, and there are 9 decision makers through which you can potentially coordinate. And here you have Michael Dustpin, and you can simply click on these three small dots, send them a connection request or directly message via Sales Navigator. So you just simply click on that, and you can contact 100 like this. And it's a really good number with the LinkedIn Sales Navigator tool. And again, you can also save searches like you did on the lead section. You can also save the account. So you have added the filters, and now you can simply toggle this on to save the searches. The filters which you added will be saved. And once you click on save searches, you will have these showing up here. I already have another save search here. So I did the safe search before, and that one is showing me now. All I do is just go to Sales Navigator and click on the safe search, and then find the decision makers and then message them by clicking on these three small dots and message icon here. One cool thing about LinkedIn Sales Navigator is that you can check out the feed. So if you go back to the home and check out the feed, it will display all of the activities done by leads which you added in the leads tab, which I showed you guys. So the leads which we saved, we are able to see all of the posts. Whatever stats and whatever posts they added in the LinkedIn, we are able to see that. So it's easier for us to find out the active LinkedIn members and to contact them to build our lead list, right? And one other cool thing which I would like to show you guys is social selling index. So it will basically give you the authenticity and how popular you are LinkedIn on your LinkedIn by your social selling index. So I'm currently one-on-one team SSI rank, so I'm ranking on 63 out of 100. So these are the four components of your social selling index, how easily you can sell. So establish your professional brand. I am close to getting it, build relationship. I have the relationship. So I'm ranking currently 63 out of 100. My goal is to take it above 80 so I can easily sell using LinkedIn Sales Navigator. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys liked it. If you do, let me know in the comments below. And if you want to learn more about generating leads for your web design or for your software business, let me know in the comments below. I'll share some more tips and tricks which I haven't shared on this video. So if you want to watch the next video, let me know in the comments below. Until next video, have a great day.